Do you know what the two leading causes of premature engine wear are? I'll give you a hint. Your customer controls one, but you have a lot of say-so in the other. Find out more in today's Mighty Minute. One leading cause of premature engine failure or engine component failure is a general lack of overall maintenance, specifically changing the engine's oil at a regular interval and checking the oil level in between those services. Now be sure to explain to your customer the importance of changing the oil at regular intervals as outlined by the OEM's maintenance schedule and help them determine whether they should be following the normal duty maintenance schedule or the more demanding severe duty maintenance schedule. You may be surprised at how many of your customers should be following the latter. Also explain to them the importance of checking the oil every time they get fuel. And if they're not sure how to do it, take the time to show them. The second most common cause of premature engine wear is the use of the incorrect oil and/or filter for the vehicle application. And that's something you certainly have a little more say in. After all, aren't you doing the oil change? Engine oil has always served several important purposes. It cleans the engine as it circulates, picking up contaminants and passing them into the oil filter where they can be collected and disposed of. Engine oil also contains additives that neutralize acids and prevent corrosion while protecting against oil breakdown. And one of its most important jobs is to provide a thin cushioning film that prevents friction between the metal engine parts as they move against each other. The film also acts as a seal between the cylinder wall and piston rings. If the oil is contaminated, or it's the wrong type, or past its prime, it won't be able to do the job it's intended to do. This is going to result in accelerated wear and premature failure of some very expensive engine components. The engines that you're servicing today are sophisticated power plants, and the engineers that design them have some very specific requirements for the oil that should be used to service them. The days of a one-size-fits-all approach have long since passed. Be sure that you always check the owner's manual or your service information system and use only an oil that meets all the requirements and certifications of the manufacturer. And remember, using quality lubricants like Mighty Engine Guard will ensure you are recommending the best protection for your customers' vehicles. Now at the beginning, I told you there are two parts to the oil change, the oil and the filter. I invite you to join me next time on the Mighty Minute when we'll talk about just that. See you then.